Weeks of watching them battle challenges from cliff diving to kayaking and mountain climbing, the Team Country Boys were eliminated last night on Expedition Impossible. We keep rubbing it in. I'm sorry.
Constantly. That's okay.
But Nick and Chad are here with us this morning to talk about their experience on the show. Good morning, guys, and thanks for being with us.
Hey. Thank you for having us, Megan.
All right, so I know you had a watch party last night, and watching this episode where, of course, you guys know how it's going to end, but no one else does. What was going through your mind there?
You know, when you're sitting there watching it, you're thinking, oh, man, I know what's about to happen, especially this time. Every week we knew it was going to happen, so it was pretty intense and exciting. But last night it was a little emotional. For Chad and I are just kind of leaning, talking to each other, like, oh, man, how are they going to portray this thing? You know, because we knew it was coming, so it was pretty intense.
What did people say after they saw that you did, in fact, get sent home last night?
Well, I mean, they were real disappointed. You know, we had a lot of people on our backs, you know, saying, we know y'all go win, y'all look so good, y'all so big guy, you know, y'all big guys, and but it wasn't really about that, and we had a couple of, we had a lot of trouble, me on the heels, and ankle and knee problems and things like that. I mean, we gave it 110%.
All right, let me ask you this. Do you have any regrets about the time that you were on the show?
None. I have no regrets.
Wouldn't do anything differently?
Maybe train differently or something. Like, near the end, I was having trouble with my feet, which, I would have done something differently as far as prepared for that, or, I don't know, run down the street barefoot or something.
But
that's the kind of stuff that I think would be a regret, is maybe train differently. Uh-huh. But as far as being out there and the experience, no way. I mean, it was the most enjoyable thing I've ever done. Most painful at the same time, but most exciting thing ever.
Were you surprised by how tough it was?
Oh, yes. Uh-huh. I mean, we thought it was going to be a little bit more Hollywood.
Oh, right.
You know, go out
like
to...
Like faking the challenge.
Right. We thought there would be a trailer at night for us to sleep
but
in.
But no?
No fancy
hotel.
Reality TV is real.
Wow. No, okay. So. I loved what the host said to you when you were eliminated, when you made it to the finish line, that he talked about what Southern gentleman you were. Mm-hmm. First of all, do you like the way that you were portrayed, and do you think this kind of changed your friendship, the three of you?
I love the way that we were portrayed, especially at the end there. And we talked about that coming up to this episode. We knew it was going to happen, and we knew that it was coming. The biggest thing for us, for him to say that, you know, for us to be among 36 other contestants, in challenges every day, and we're in the middle of Africa, and for him to notice that and make that comment, you know, we wanted to represent Mississippi from the beginning. Right. We certainly wanted to represent it with a prize at the end. But even without the win, we were proud to say, we're from Mississippi, and we are. We're Southern gentlemen. That's what we want the world to see, and see about Mississippi, too.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And you think you're closer now after going through this?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I can say we're probably like brothers now. Uh-huh. You know, we left as friends, and we came back. I mean, I'm in a tent with these guys for a month, so I mean.
That's real close.
Yeah, I mean, it was a little griping every once in a while, but I mean, we really showed a lot of love, you know.
I have to ask you this. You know, y'all did struggle through a few of these challenges, but you never saw on TV you really yelling at each other or getting in each other's face. Did that happen and it just wasn't shown, or were you really just that
constantly
like that?
There was one time, it doesn't matter when it was, but we were coming up a hill, and of course what am I going to yell at my best friend about? I mean, it is what it is. We're out there, and, you know, there were times I was struggling, Chad was struggling. We were just going back and forth.
Telling the truth.
The truth.
We were going up the hill.
Yeah.
We were going up the hill, and he said, I was struggling. He said it was the finish line.
Okay.
And when I got up on the hill, it wasn't the finish line. It was a checkpoint.
I didn't know that.
They tricked you.
So I felt like I was lied to. But I didn't have enough energy to fight him at the time. So he told me,
get me down off this mountain and then I'll fight you.
I'll see you later. Yeah. All right. Well, we want to hear so much more from you guys. And we're going to, including what's next for you and who you're pulling for now on the show, now that your journey is over. So stick around for a little bit.
We'll do it.
And we're going to come back. You stick around, too. We'll be back in just 2 minutes. You're watching.